Conway's Law was the idea that what we create is a reflection of our communication patterns. Specifically, he was talking about software, but we can take a broader approach for a second. Silos are often simply communication models. It's the way in which decision-making and sort of ownership around a particular set of problems gets discussed. And so one way that you can start to break down the silo, which is the first step, like if it's animosity that's developed, the first step is bringing those people into your people, right? What you want is you want to stop having the perspective that the silo is the thing. I often tell organizations to stop shipping their org chart. The very first thing that happens typically as we see that we're good at something is we want to double down on that value. And so we do that by declaring, this team does X. And so we start to align and concentrate on a functional silo. We put all the like things together. Let me try to address the history for a second, right? I often ask development teams and people doing the DevOps transformation, I ask them this simple question, does a DBA need a database? And then people look at me like I have nine heads, right? But of course a DBA doesn't need a database. DBAs were created in some way by software engineers who didn't want to deal with the underlying complexity. They needed a place to store their data, but they didn't want to have to deal with the runtime consequences of bringing that database in. And so right off the bat in that model, a silo gets created through a particular kind of conversation. As a software developer, my value is solving problems with code. Surely there must be some other place, some other functional group that can be accountable for the build aspects of my software, that can be responsible for the infrastructure required to run it, who can manage it in production. So we can talk about all of these ways in which I can maximize my personal value as a software developer by not being distracted by the consequences of the choices I make. And I think that DevOps takes a totally different approach. It says, sure, there are a number of skills that need to be applied in order to ensure that the software and technology that we build is stable in production. But it does not, the approach that it takes is one in which, is an inclusive one, that says we are all sort of co-responsible. So yeah, bring it, right? If you're a database expert, bring that expertise into the team. But what I'm not gonna do is I'm not gonna force you into a box in which that's the only way that you can express your creative intelligence with relation to this product that we're putting out in the world. As a matter of fact, I don't want that because you have had a broad history and career. You probably have, there's probably a lot of awesome that you can bring. In terms of understanding that product, in terms of understanding how it works in the world. So the approach that I would take toward the animosity would be first to heal it, right? Like the first thing you wanna do is you wanna meet the people in the silo. Hey. I'm right over here. Like my sort of, a lot of people have the open spaces now. My desk is right over there. I would introduce yourself. I would get to understand how and why you were separated by understanding what value these people bring, how they express that value. And then I would look for places where you can combine to improve something in the infrastructure. I'd bring that idea of sort of Kaizen to that's sort of gradual change over time or team improvement over time. I would bring that idea to your interactions. So it's nice to get to know people. It's great to make friends at work. And I think that that's the basis. Hi, who are you? This is who I am. What do you do? This is what I do. I think the very next step is how can we work together to make something that's better than what we have today?